All right, today I think I'm going to work on these rust holes here in the fenders. My plan is to repair them on the truck and then take them off and then fix the inner fender. So that's my plan, is to try to fix them on the truck and cut these out. I may not be able to get back in here to cut this one. We'll see if I can get in there with my grinder. So let me get you set up over here. It's a beautiful day outside. I really don't want to shut the garage door, but I think I'm going to have to. So let me do that. Well, now it looks like I gotta give some artificial light. Alright, that's not too bad. So these holes have been in there a long time, just like everything else. But when they first popped through, I covered them with duct tape. So that could have contributed to some of the continuing rust. So I think I'm going to try to cut. Boy, see if I can stay up here. We'll see. I think I need to take this out. So I'm going to kick the compressor on. See if I can zap that out of there with my impact. Wow. I'm surprised that that came out that easy, but it did. Don't try this at home, kids. And if you do, make sure you got gloves and stuff on. Yeah. Alright, now I gotta figure out how I'm gonna cut that. Usually a small die grinder. You see what I've got? I've got a small die grinder. I just don't know if I have it. All right, so I've got it all cut out now, and now I'm going to start making the piece that's going to go back in there. And so I'll set the camera up here and you can kind of watch that process. And like I said, I'm just going to get it in there and then tack it, weld it, you know, as much as I can. But I'm going to want to weld underneath once I get done, weld back under here and re-grind it under this edge here. So mostly just tacks on this side just to make it look good. And then I think I'm going to take and trim this edge because I've got to kind of make this roll. This was rotted out really bad. So I'm going to do a little more trimming. Okay, here we go. So it's got to be 17 and a half long. We'll be popping in and out here. I And then it needs to be 1 5/8. At 13 5/8, it needs to be a little wider. It's going to be 2 inches. So we've got to bend it a little bit. So, use what you got, right? Okay, I'm going to use my shear. These things are great. They zip right through that sheet metal. Well, just right lengthwise. If I square so air tools work really nice. If you got enough air to run them, that's one of the problems, is having enough air to run the tool. So That's why I like these electric ones. They let you they give you a little more power. You don't have to have such a huge air. You don't have to have such a huge air compressor if you're. So they come in handy if you have a big air compressor, but I don't have a huge air compressor, so for these little trimming, they work pretty good. Okay. I kind of like that. So let's see if we can get the welder to plug in. Well, that's not good.
Why didn't you guys tell me I was getting that crooked? Gotta cut that now. Not paying attention.
Okay, so there's the patch. That's another one of those that I've been wanting to fix for a long time. But that's how I'll leave it until I take the fender off and then finish welding it and grinding it, and I'll be able to get in there and shape this and make it look like you'll never know it was ever rotted out. Looks good.